Hello everyone, continuing with unit 4, that is balancing of rotating masses. Till now we have studied various topics like introduction to balancing of rotating masses, then why balancing, then types of balancing, static and dynamic balancing. Then we have taken the case of balancing of single rotating mass by balancing mass in same plane. Then we have studied balancing of single rotating mass by balancing mass in different planes. Now, in this session, we will be discussing balancing of several rotating masses by balancing masses in same plane. So, this balancing of several rotating masses by balancing mass in same plane is also a problem of static balancing. So, we have studied balancing of single rotating mass by a single mass rotating in same plane and by two masses rotating in different planes. Now in this session we'll be discussing balancing of different masses rotating in same plane. So let's start with case 3, that is balancing of different masses rotating in the same plane. This balancing of different masses rotating in the same plane, we'll solve it by analytical method and will also solve it by graphical method. So as we have done earlier also, consider an axis xx as an axis of rotation where mass m1, m2, m3 and m4 are four masses at radius r1, r2, r3 and r4 respectively from the center of rotation. This blue dot shows the center of rotation where mass m1, m2, m3 and m4 are acting on the same plane at a radial distance of r1, r2, r3 and r4 respectively from the center of rotation. That is R1, R2, R3, R4 are the radii of rotation of mass M1, M2, M3 and M4 respectively. Let the centrifugal forces due to these revolving masses, that is FC1, FC2, FC3 and FC4 makes an angle theta1, theta2, theta3 and theta4 respectively with horizontal axis. We are making the figure, that is we have force FC1, that is the centrifugal force of magnitude FC1, FC2, FC3 and FC4 at an angle of theta1, theta2, theta3 and theta4 degrees respectively with the horizontal. The magnitude and the direction of the balancing mass may be obtained analytically as discussed below. First, we will make all these forces resolved in the horizontal plane, then we'll resolve all these forces in vertical plane. So first of all, finding out the centrifugal force or the product of mass and its radius of rotation, taking omega square common as the magnitude of centrifugal forces, mr omega square. So we'll take omega common for all the masses. So first of all, find out the centrifugal force exerted by each mass on the rotating shaft. Then resolve the centrifugal force horizontally and vertically and find their vector sum. That is, we know that sum of horizontal components of the centrifugal forces sigma h is equals to m1 r1 cos theta 1 plus m2 r2 cos theta 2 plus m3 r3 cos theta 3 plus m4 r4 cos theta 4. That is m1 r1 cos theta 1 plus m2 r2 cos theta 2 plus m3 r3 cos theta 3 and m4 r4 cos theta 4. Where theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4 are the angles made by the masses m1, m2, m3, m4 with x-axis. In the figure I have not shown, but you can draw it on your own. In the same way, the sum of vertical components of the centrifugal forces will be the sine components, that is sigma v will be m1 r1 sin theta 1 plus m2 r2 sin theta 2 plus m3 r3 sin theta 3 plus m4 r4 sin theta 4. So we have sigma h and we have magnitude of sigma v, knowing the values of all the masses and all the radius of rotations at various angles. So getting the value of sigma h and sigma v by analytical method, we can get the resultant. The magnitude of the resultant centrifugal force will be under root of sigma h square plus sigma v square. So the resultant R will have the magnitude equals to under root sigma h whole square plus sigma v whole square, which will be at certain angle. Let that angle be theta. If theta is the angle which resultant force makes with the horizontal, that is the angle made by the resultant force with the horizontal is say theta, so then 10 theta will be equals to ratio of sigma v upon sigma h, that is ratio of sigma v and sigma h will give the value of 10 theta. So 10 inverse sigma v upon sigma h will give the magnitude of angle theta. So this resultant means if all the forces, that is force fc1 fc2 fc3 fc4, if all the forces are replaced by a single force and in the direction theta, it will have the same effect as the combined effect by these masses m1 m2 m3 m4 respectively. So to balance this, the balancing force is then equal to the resultant force but in opposite directions. That means we can replace these four forces by a single resultant force which will give the combined effect, and to balance it we'll place a force which is the balancing force of magnitude equal to the resultant but in the opposite direction, whose magnitude of mass will be mb and it will be at a radial distance rb from the center of rotation. So now find out the magnitude of the balancing mass such that this R, which is the resultant of all the centrifugal forces, is equals to mb into rb. And knowing the radius of rotation of the balancing mass, which is lying in the same plane as of m1, m2, m3 and m4 respectively, we can get the magnitude of balancing mass mb. Clear? This is the analytical approach for getting the balancing of different masses rotating in the same plane. Now with the same problem where four masses m1, m2, m3, m4 at a radial distance r1, r2, r3, r4 respectively are acting and producing a outward centrifugal force fc1, fc2, fc3 and fc4 respectively, we can have a solution using graphical approach. So using graphical method, first draw a space diagram with the position of several masses. As shown, we have drawn a space diagram. Here I have already shown the resultant, but in the space diagram need not to show the resultant because the resultant will be by the graphical method. In step 2, find out the centrifugal forces or the product of mass and radius of rotation exerted by each mass, that is m1 r1 will give fc1, m2 r2 will give fc2, m3 r3 will fc3 and m4 r4 as fc4, taking omega square common. So it will, for graphical approach, omega square will be the magnitude of its enlargement. So step 3 will be draw the vector diagram with the obtained centrifugal forces or the product of mass and radius of rotation. To draw the vector diagram, take a suitable scale. We'll take a suitable scale of any magnitude and we'll draw the vector diagram or the force diagram for getting the balanced mass. Now let A, B, B, C, C, D and D, E represent the forces FC1, FC2, FC3 and FC4 on the vector diagram. I'll draw the vector diagram. Now we'll draw AB, let's draw it simultaneously. So let's draw the vector polygon or the force polygon, that is vector diagram along with. So we have seen that for the graphical method, first of all we'll draw a space diagram with the positions of several masses as we have already shown. Then we'll find out the centrifugal force or the product of mass and radius of rotation exerted by each mass. Then we'll draw the vector diagram with the obtained centrifugal force or the product of the masses and radius of rotation. That is, we have got the magnitude of FC1, FC2, FC3 and FC4 taking omega common. Now we'll draw the force polygon also. So for this, let AB, BC, CD and DE represent the forces FC1, FC2, FC3 and FC4 on the vector diagram. So let's take point A. From point A, we'll draw a vector AB, that is small AB, of magnitude FC1 in the direction of this mass M1, which is seen from the space diagram. And we'll take some suitable scale. So we'll draw a vector of magnitude M1R1, which will represent the magnitude and direction of force FC1. So this vector AB represents the centrifugal force FC1. Then from point B, in the direction of M2, we'll draw a vector BC, which represents FC2. Then for FC3, we'll take the direction of this mass M3. From point C, draw a vector of magnitude M3R3, which represents FC3. And in the same way, from point D, we'll draw a vector DE, which will represent the magnitude of FC4, that is M4R4, in the direction of force M4. Now we'll draw, as I have just said, we'll draw AB parallel to force FC1 of the space diagram. At B, draw a line parallel to force FC2. Similarly, draw line CD, DE parallel to FC3 and FC4 respectively. I mentioned these steps so that you can recall with the force polygon, and then you'll see this step, or first you see this step, then so it will make you clear. So as per polygon law of forces, the closing side AE represent the resultant force in the magnitude and direction as shown in vector diagram. So this AE represents the resultant of these four centrifugal forces using graphical method. So this R represents the resultant of forces which contains the balancing mass at a balancing radius, that is, that contains MB, RB. So the balancing force is then equal and opposite to the resultant force R. So determine the magnitude of balancing mass MB at a given radius of rotation RB, which is equal to capital R. Hope you are clear with. So for more videos, You can subscribe to my YouTube channel, that is Gagan Bansal. Or for any query, you can directly mail me at gaganbansal12345@gmail.com. Thank you so much.